Second numerical question: design a combined footing to support two columns of sizes 400 by 400 mm each. Okay, both the column size are 400 by 400 mm. Carrying factored loads of 600 kilonewton and 800 kilonewton. The columns are spaced at 4 meter center to center apart. Okay, the footing projection is restricted to 0.5 meter from the center of a column carrying 600 kilonewton. The SPC of the soil is 150 kilonewton per meter square. Use M20 grade of concrete and Fe 250 grade steel for footing. Let us write down the given data. W load ultimate, U stands for ultimate load of column A. So there are two columns, we'll name them as A and B. So the ultimate load of column on column A is 600 kilonewton. Ultimate load on column B is 800 kilonewton. So total ultimate load coming on the footing is 1400 kilonewton. Projection is given from column A, from the center of the column A. Offset or projection is limited to 0.5 meter from column A, because see, 600 kilonewton is coming on column A. We have considered this as column A. So the projection from column A, okay, this is 0.5 meter. SPC of the soil is equal to 150 kilonewton per meter square. The cross sectional area of column A and B are 400 mm by 400 mm each. The spacing between the two columns is 4 meter center to center. Assume the weight of the footing as 10% of the load, ultimate load coming on the footing. So it turns out to be 140 kilonewton. Total factored load on the soil will be 1400 plus weight of the footing 140. It turns out to be 540 kilonewton. So the required area of the footing, it depends upon the stress on the soil. So area required is equal to summation of the ultimate load coming on the footing plus weight of the footing upon safe bearing capacity of the soil. So 1400 plus 140 upon 150, it turns out to be 10.267 meters square. Okay. Next point, location of the resultant. Here we are taking moments from point A, okay, from the column A. So turns out to be 600 into 0 plus 800 into 4 meter. It should be equal to resultant load is 1400 into XA. Okay. So if you solve this equation, XA is unknown, it turns out to be 2.29 meters. So check out the figure. The distance between A and B is 4 meters. In that, XA will be 2.29 and the remaining will be XB, that is 1.71 meters. Now, we know that PA plus XA should be equal to PB plus XB. Okay, so here PA is given 0.5 meters, XA we have found out to be 2.29 meters, PB we have to find, XB is 1.71 meters. So here only XB is the unknown. If you solve this equation, you get XB is equal to 1.08 meters. Now, length of the footing is equal to PA, XA, PB, XB. Okay. So it turns out to be 5.58 meters. Now area of the footing is equal to length into breadth, since it's a rectangle. So length we have calculated here, it is 5.58 meters. So if you divide the area upon this length, you will get the breadth of the footing. It turns out to be 1.84 meters. Now round it off to a higher number and round it off to 2.0 meters. Next, area of the footing provided. Calculate, multiply these two, length into breadth, you will get the total area provided, 11.16, compared to 10.267 meters square. Okay. Now, stresses, actual stress on the soil, it is nothing but total load coming on the soil upon area of the footing provided. 1540 upon 11.16 turns out to be 138 kilonewton per meter square. This is less than the SPC, which is 150 kilonewton per meter square. Hence, adopt this size. It is safe. Now, stresses on the top of the footing, it is nothing but the load coming on the footing upon the area of the footing. Okay. area provided. So it is nothing but 1400 upon 11.16, it turns out to be 125.44 kilonewton per meter square. Next main calculation is shear force. Here we have to take P as 250.88. See, since this is the breadth, we have taken as 2 meters. So if you multiply stress into breadth, you will get P. Okay, P value. It is nothing but 250.88 kilonewton per meter here. So at the end, first part, at the end, left end, extreme end, shear force will be 0. Okay. Next, at just left of A, calculate 120. Oh, this is 250.88 into the projection, it is given 0.5 meter from the center of column A. It turns out to be 125.44 kilonewton. Next, just right of A. I can show you the figure. Just left of A, shear force will be 0. At the left end, shear force will be 0. Just left of A, it would be P into 0.5. Just right of A, it would be P into 0.5 minus 600, and so on. Okay? Get. Just left of A is 250 into 0.5, that is 125. Next, just right of A, 125 minus 600, you will get 474.56. Same way, just left of B, it is nothing but 250 into 4.5 minus 600, you get 529.1 kilonewton. Just right of B, 529.1 kilonewton minus 800 is the load coming on the column B. So it turns out to be 271 kilonewton. Shear force just right of me, and at the right end, extreme right end, the shear force will be 0. Now, next point, calculate point of contraflexure. It would be 250.89 into x meters equal to 600. So this is upward force and pressure upwards. This is the load coming from the column, they both should be equal. So here x is the unknown, it turns out to be 2.39 meters from the left end, okay, from the left extreme end. And what is the distance from the column A? It is nothing but 2.39 minus projection of from the column A, it turns out to be 1.89 meters. Okay, next, bending moment. At the left extreme, it would be 0. At point A, it is nothing but 250.89, that is upward pressure, into x square by 2. X is nothing but the projection here. 0.5 square upon 2 turns out to be 31.36 kilonewton meter. Next, bending moment at B, 250.89 into, this is the distance from the left extreme to the column B, 4 plus 0.5 turns out to be 4.5 square upon 2 minus moment from the column, 600 kilonewton into 4 meters from column A to column B. It turns out to be 140.26 kilonewton meter. And the bending moment at the right end, extreme end, it would be 0. Okay. Next, bending moment at the point of contraflexure, you will get, where you will get maximum Hawking bending moment. This is nothing but Wx square by 2, since it is UDL, 250.89 upward pressure into x square. This x square 2.39, we have got it here, 2.39 from the left extreme to the point of contraflexion. Okay, then minus 600 into this one, 2.39 minus 0.5, we have got it here, point of contraflexion distance from column A. So the moment from the column A is 600 into 1.89. So the net answer you will get minus 417.49 kilonewton meter. Now we have obtained the shear force and bending moment values. Plot a graph for these values. You will get SFT and BMD in this fashion. Okay. Now, calculation of the depth of the footing. We have two considerations, one from punching shear and one from bending moment. So, punching shear calculated for both the columns, but here, since the column sizes are same, we can calculate it for maximum load. So maximum load will be 800, that is for column B. So the area of, this is the perimeter of the column into overall depth capital D into safe punching shear stress, that is, I have taken it as 1 kilonewton, okay, per meter square. This is all in terms of meters. Here the load coming on the column is 800 minus pressure, upward pressure on the column area. It is nothing but 125 into 0.4 square. This turns out to be, the depth turns out to be 487.5 millimeter overall depth. But from bending moment consideration, we have mu is equal to 0.138 fck bd square. Substitute all these values. M is nothing but the maximum honking bending moment. So d turns out to be depth. This effective depth turns out to be 234 millimeter. So the maximum among these two is 487. But from shear point, shear force this one consideration, we'll adopt d of minimum 550 millimeters. Capital D is equal to 550 millimeters. Say choose a die reinforcement die as 20 mm and a clear cover of 60 millimeters. So small d effective depth turns out to be 550 minus 60 minus 20. Okay, this turns out to be 470 millimeters. Okay. Now calculation of steel for Hawking bending moment at mid span. We have this equation mu by bd square. Calculate this. We substitute mu and B and D, it turns out to be 1.07. From this equation, calculate PT, percentage of tensile reinforcement. Substitute all these values. 4.6 is constant. This is FCK. This is MU by BD square. This is FI upon FCK. This turns out to be, PT turns out to be 0.527. For this PT, calculate AST, area of steel. That is nothing but PT BD upon 100. PT is 0.527, B 1000, D is 470 upon 100, you will get 2477 millimeter square. For this area, you have to provide steel. Say I will provide die 25 mm steel. The area spacing will be area upon AST into 1000. This turns out to be 198 millimeters. I will adopt a spacing of 180 millimeter center to center. But we have to also check for minimum steel required for a slab. It is nothing but 0.12% into BD. This turns out to be 564 millimeter. This is very small when compared to this one. Okay. Now distribution steel is also 0.12% of BD. This is also same 564 millimeter square. So I will provide die 12 mm at 300 mm center to center. Now last step is check for shear at the projection. Okay. Tau V is nothing but VU upon BD. VU is 138. Into 1.71 upon B into D. B is 1 meter, D is 0.47. So this turns out to be 0.502 newton per millimeter square. So this is tau V. Now how to calculate tau C? We have this formula, 100 AST V upon BD. Here AST is nothing but AST provided, not the AST required. Okay, calculate from this one. 25 dia at 180 center to center, you will get 2727 millimeter square. Substitute it in this equation, you will get tau C as 0.58. See here, tau C is greater than tau V. Tau C is greater than tau V. Hence, this is safe in shear. This completes the design of combined footing. Okay.